Hello, I'm Mr. R. Nidja, a retired lecturer in metallurgy preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Here I'm giving an exposition of the living bread of life that Christ Jesus, our anointed elder brother, has brought into this world for us to eat and have an eternal life. I'm doing Gospels, John 6, verse 28 onward. Then they said to him, the men of letters, you know, which were following Jesus, what must we do to be doing the works of God? Jesus answered them, this is the work of God, that you believe in him whom he has sent. That means Christ Jesus himself is the work of God. What he is doing, you should do the same. So they said to him, then what sign do you do that we may see and believe you? They wanted to see a sign, you know. Sign are shown to the people who are once born, who are believing. The miracle Jesus performed, healing the sick boy and all that, you know, they were the signs. Nicodemus saw the sign that he comes from God. But these people, you know, they were stooges of their priest. So they couldn't understand. Whatever their priest tells them, they believe. So the Rabbi themselves, they were drunk with the old wine of the letters. They do not want to know the new wine, or not to be superseded. As these dog-collared people, you see them today, they are all antichrist. And they are the copy of the temple priest who resisted the supremacy of Christ Jesus. So these dog-collared priests, they have created dark, more darkness than before. Filling Matthew 12, verse 43 to 45, the arid temple spirit then occupied the church of God and created these dog-collared priests and all that nonsense. Jesus answered them, this is the work of God, that you believe in him whom he has sent. So they said to him, then what sign do you do that we may see and believe you? They have seen all the signs, bread being produced, the sick healed, all that, you know. But still they were not satisfied because they were spiritually blind, so they would not see. What work do you perform? Our fathers ate the manna in the wilderness, as it is written, he gave them bread from heaven to eat. Jesus then compared that manna to the bread I given them to from heaven to eat, which was much tastier than manna. Jesus then said to them, truly, truly, I say to you, it was not Moses who gave you the bread from heaven, but my Father gave you the true bread from, true bread from heaven. Moses gave the manna was produced on earth, you know. It was not come from heaven, which Jesus produced of supernatural power. Manna was produced by nature. This heavenly bread was produced by supernature of our Father, through the supernatural power of our Father. So this was much tastier and life-giving. For the bread of God is he who comes down from heaven and gives life to the world. that is the bread of life, mean his word. Bread of God is his word. When you eat it with your ears and digest it over your heart and preach it from your own mouth, then drinking the blood of Christ, and then you know you enjoy it. It is much fragrance. It not smell like toilet smells. It fragrance, you know, opposite. So that is the bread of life which our Father has given to us through our anointed elder brother Christ Jesus. They said to him, Sir, give us this bread always. Then they said, you know, it was tasty, you know. They say, oh, give us bread always, you know. Jesus said to them, I am the bread of life. Whoever comes to me shall not hunger. Jesus is the bread of life, because when he spoke the word of God, that is the bread. You need to have ears to eat it. If you don't have ears to eat it, you can't have the bread. So you need to have ears free of wax and the skin free of the old wine, letters of the wine. That is why Christ Philip said, a Gentile never dies, for he does not live to die. Samaritan man who picked up the wounded person, he was a living in spirit. Such a person loved to have this bread. Not those in Jerusalem. Jesus said to them, I am the bread of life. Whoever comes to me shall not hunger, and whoever believes in me shall never thirst. Now, people are, you know, seeking, desiring his word. They want to know gospel. They want to understand gospel. But if they don't develop their ears to hear his word, they can't have it. Ask, seek, and knock is the way to develop them. But once you develop it, you know, then take it to your heart, start digesting, and when you preach gospel, drinking the blood of Christ, more you drink the blood of Christ, more is given to you. So you will never thirst again. You will brew in your heart through intuition or logical reasoning. And you will always be brewing afresh. His word cannot be written down in ink on paper, but over the living tablet of our heart. So once your heart has been opened to Christ Jesus and you start writing gospel over your heart by eating the flesh of Jesus and drinking the blood of Christ, you will never thirst again. But I said to you that you have seen me, yet you do not believe. So Jesus said to them, you know, you see me talking to you, but you do not believe me because your ears are full of hardened wax. All that the Father gives me will come to me. That is, you receive gospel from our Father, and no one else, not even from Christ Jesus. Christ Jesus has the living bread. You must eat it with your ears. And then with the will of our Father, you will be able to digest it and able to preach gospel, drink the blood of Christ. That is by the grace of our Father. Remember that Peter was with Jesus all the time, but he was once born. He never had the taste of gospel. And Jesus gave him the taste of gospel when he said, Peter, what do you think of me? He said, you are the living Christ of living God. Then Jesus told him, unless my Father gives you, you can't have it. So gospel is received always from our Father. And we preach it in honor of Christ Jesus to glorify our Father. Jesus also glorified our Father. We also glorify our Father. We don't glorify Jesus. We honor him, highly honor him for giving us this living bread. All that the Father gives me will come to me. So all that my Father gives to me, come to me. I can't give it to you. I can just preach like Christ Jesus did, like a sower. Some seed fell on flat ground, some on rocky soil, some on other soils. But people don't understand what these soils are. So you need to have developed a taste in spiritual language before you can start eating the flesh of Jesus. And whoever comes to me, I will never cast out. That means if somebody comes to me and asks me to explain gospel, I will explain to him. I won't throw him out. Now I put these t-shirts. You can see, no Christ in your heart, no gospel and all that, you know. And there's on the back also. But hardly anyone stops me and asks me what is written on it. In the whole year, maybe 10 people will say, Mr. Nidjar, can you just let me read what is written in front of you, front and back? Very few, you know. And then they won't ask me. They will just think, oh, I'm a crazy man. So same was Jesus was, people were thinking he was a crazy man. And would not believe in him. So with this I will stop it so that video doesn't become long again.